It is all over but the crying or the bragging or the blaming. Pick the verb that fits. The House chamber here can go back to being a tourist stop because the session did end. And as Governor Dayton said, just like anything with a divided government, sometimes everyone's going to get something they like and something they don't.
As night descended, there was still plenty of tension about the last-minute nature of it all.
20 minutes of explanation on 672 pages. That's all we've had.
This is not Illinois. This is not California. We do not have that sort of corruption here.
But around 3 in the morning, it was over.
The motion prevails, and this special session is adjourned. Sine die.
Republicans in the House and Senate had a lot to celebrate.
We stopped the collapse of the health care system. We promised roads and bridges bill, which we haven't had since 2008, and the most significant tax relief we've had in almost 2 decades.
Most of the surplus, $650 million, will be used for tax cuts. Another large chunk, $300 million, will go to roads and bridges, money normally spent on other state services.
I think common sense dictates that Minnesotans expect you to use the money they've already given you to pay for what they want you to pay for, which is use the surplus to pay for roads and bridges. So I think they'll be happy with what we've done.
There's also a bonding bill that will go to things as diverse as wastewater treatment, to small town power plants, to historic Fort Snelling. It's now in the hands of Governor Dayton.
Well, I've said I'm genuinely undecided. I never committed to sign any of these final 11 bills. I haven't had a chance to review them myself. My staff is in the process of reviewing them now.
The governor previously said that he'd veto the local preemption bill, which bars cities from raising the local minimum wage. But something that drew protesters to the Capitol this week, state worker pensions and family leave, was added to that bill.
Just cruel. Just cruel to do that to good people.
Now, Governor Dayton will have just a few days, to decide on the higher education bill and the ag bill, because those were passed during the regular session. But all these bills that just now passed in the special session, he'll have 2 weeks to mull those over. And the one he's most likely to veto, or the one that there's a lot of speculation about anyway, is the tax bill, because that takes such a huge chunk out of the surplus. But that's the bill Republicans fought for the hardest. So we'll see how that one turns out. Back to you, Randy.